Hey people, Scott-chan here, and welcome to a new video to my channel. Today I thought about showing you my N64 collection, or Nintendo 64. So, let's jump to it. So first I just need to find my N64 games here. I have it in myself here. I don't have so many, but I'm starting to get a few good ones, like Bomberman 64. I haven't been collecting so much the last few months, but this last winter I actually got a few good ones, so I'm looking forward to showing you. So here are my N64 games. I have about 6. I used to have only 2, so it's starting to get a little bit. So first off, let's see here. First off, we have Super Mario 64. Of course, every N64 console needs to have it. It came with the N64 console. It also came with MRC, a car game for the boys, you know. So yeah, they came with it. I haven't played this so much, but I've played this a little bit. I'm a bigger fan of the DS version. But actually, a short little memory here. When I was in kindergarten, I actually played this game once on an N64, and it was super magical. I've never had anything as magical as that since then, kind of, or in some other standard. So it has actually been a long time goal since I was a little toddler, it's called, to own an N64 and play Super Mario 64. I of course became super happy when I got the DS version a few years later. And then after that, I bought Star Wars Shadow of the Empire. This was a game I really wanted because it was a third person story based game in the Star Wars universe for the N64. It was pretty good. Not the best movie, but the N64 haven't aged that well, of course. But it's a pretty decent, good game. I know I of course want some of the other Star Wars games, even though they aren't story-based. I really want to test them out. And after that, we have a real gold mine, and that is GoldenEye. I bought this game about 1 year ago. It arrived April 1st, and I actually got it pretty cheap, about under 20 bucks in total with the shipping and everything. I won it at an auction on eBay, and this game is a game that you easily will find super expensive, so it was pretty cool to find it super cheap. And this game has actually aged a bit better than the other games, if you ask me. I think that first-person shooters on the N64 is pretty decent. And this one was especially pretty good. I loved every second of it, even though I played only half of it. But it's a nice shooter, and it's a nice story. And I also love GoldenEye the movie, and Pierce Brosnan as James Bond. It's one of my favorites. And after that, I actually got another shooter, and that was Turok Dinosaur Hunter. This game really surprised me a lot. I liked GoldenEye a lot, and even though it has aged a little bit better than other games, it's still a little bit primitive. But this game, it felt pretty modern. I'm pretty sure it came out the same year as GoldenEye, but the animation and controls was way smoother and more like a PS2 game than a N64 game. It was at the early beginning of it. I have only played the first stage because I need a memory card, which I don't have, but it's a pretty awesome game. Good animation, good controls. It's slightly different than GoldenEye and doesn't match up so much with the modern controls. It's a little bit flipped, but it's still a pretty awesome game. And then, last on my list, is Bomberman 64. I rather wanted the Bomberman Hero, it's called, but this was a pretty good side game, you can say. You know, a nice puzzle game if you want to just sit down and relax. It's also 3D, so it's pretty funny to combine the traditional Bomberman game with the 3D style. It works perfectly, it still has that kind of square-like feeling. So, it's a pretty nice game to have on the side. I kind of like this a little bit better than the Super Mario 64, but that's mostly because I've played Super Mario 64 a lot more though, so this was a little bit refreshing. So those were my N64 games. I'm still collecting, but I'm taking a little break right now to focus on other consoles like the GameCube, where I recently got the Wind Waker for the first time. But it's a really solid collection if you ask me, and the N64 is a pretty nice console to collect for. It's some of the games you can find pretty cheap, some you can find pretty expensive, but there are many stellar classics like Ocarina of Time and the Super Mario 64. I love both of those games, and mostly their re-release on the DS and 3DS. But they also have many other classics, Donkey Kong and Mario Kart. So thank you so much for watching my N64 collection. It was pretty fun to make it. And I see you all next time. Goodbye.